for the 17th running of the Dubai World Cup. Live here on Moor 4 from Maidan in Dubai, they break away. And Master of Hounds broke out sharply in the yellow jacket and closely pursued by So You Think, who goes on in the early stages. Transcend is bustled up for Japan on the outside, wants the lead badly. Out wide is Capone, the pace does look strong. Royal Delta's just in behind those, the filly from Master of Hounds, now back in fifth on the inside. Monterosso is close up in a white cap then, followed by Zazu. Aishin Flash round the inside, Game On Dude and Chantal Sutherland, a little bit worse than the midfield. She's got in fairly well, she's three wide as they run towards the back straight. Behind those then is Planter, Mendip, Prince Bishop towards the back, and last of all is Smart Falcon. Heading into the back straight, and Transcend has got to the lead and got across to the rail as well. Leads by a half length to Capone, So You Think, and Joseph O'Brien though looking to get up the inside of Transcend there, and does so. That was a great move by young Joseph there. He just edged Transcend off the inner, and now he's in a good position. Out wide is Capone. Game On Dude making ground on the outside, spot the blue cap. Just in behind them is Royal Delta. Then Zazu in the green and white striped sleeves. Planteur is out wide. Behind the Master of Hounds on the rail. Further back is Mendip. Also towards the rear, Asian Flash in the black sleeves. They're leaving the back straight, and then Smart Falcon. And now it's getting serious here. Capone in the noseband. So You Think in pole position, right on the rail. What can he find up the straight? In behind them in the white cap, Monterosso coming forward in the hands of Mikel Barcelona. As now they stretch, and it's Capone for Godolphin. Capone leading the way. Ahmed Ashtabi challenged by his stable companion Monterosso. It's Capone and Monterosso. So You Think a little bit heavy-legged on the far side. Planteur is finishing off well, but Monterosso, who was third 12 months ago behind Victoire Pisa, storms into the lead in the hands of Mikel Barcelona, the derby-winning jockey on Pour Moir last year, and he's now going to lift the Dubai World Cup, and he celebrates in similar extravagant fashion on the winner, Monterosso, with tight second Planteur alongside with Capone, then So You Think, and still he's punching the air is Mikel Barcelona, followed home then by Master of Hounds and Zazu, and then Asian Flash and Royal Delta, and then towards the tail, Smart Falcon, Transcend, Mendip, and Game On Dude, who was disappointing. Absolutely jubilant Mikel Barcelona, recently signed up by Godolphin, and last year when he won the derby on Pour Moir, he saluted the crowd and only won very narrowly. He had a lot more in hand today. He's lifted another big one, the biggest prize in the world, on Monterosso in the Godolphin colours, and Sheikh Mohammed, who masterminds the team, rightly ecstatic.
Well, there are huge noises from an appreciative crowd here. The Dubai and local crowd absolutely delighted that Sheikh Mohammed has won the Dubai World Cup. And Monterosso, a son of Dubawi, one of the Sheikh's leading staff. Look at that. This man, Barcelona, is extraordinary. This is the young jockey that stood up in the irons when he won the derby on Pour Moir by a short head last summer. And it's a 1-2 for Godolphin with Capone in second. And up on the outside, Planteur just relegating So You Think into fourth. Back in fifth then was a good run then by Zazu in that colour change there. Followed then on the inside by the striped jacket of Aishin Flash, who ran well. Chantal Sutherland was involved a little bit there getting into the race, turning to the home straight, but the run didn't really sustain itself. Well beaten was Smart Falcon, who got barged as he left the stalls. And those rumours about him being not right when he arrived from Japan. Monterosso started life out, trained by Mark Johnston up at Midland for Sheikh Hamdan bin Mohammed.
the trophy presentation being made to, of course, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed and all of the connections there, His Highness Sheikh Hamdan bin Rashid Al Maktoum, who'll be representing the sponsors. And there we are, that is what it's all about, the Dubai World Cup. It's worth $10 million and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed lifts it in celebration to all of the crowd here at Maidan. Those 80,000 people here really, really enjoying this moment and fully appreciate all of the work that His Highness Sheikh Mohammed puts into horse racing. His Excellency Sheikh Rashid bin Mohammed Al Maktoum there, also on the podium, along with Sheikh Hamdan bin Mohammed as well. Another winner for His Highness Sheikh Mohammed, who has expanded his Godolphin operation even more over the last couple of years. Don't forget, of course, he hired this trainer, Mahmoud Al-Zarouni, 2 years ago to work alongside Saeed bin Saroor. He's also recruited two new jockeys to his stream, Macar Barcelona and Sylvester D'Souza, to ride with Frankie Dettori. And look at that, Mahmoud Al-Zarouni, former assistant to Ali Rashid Arai, has proven that he is a very, very good horseman. He knows the time of day when it comes to training winners, and you can't get any better than saddling the winner of the world's richest horse race alongside the jockey Mikhail Barcelona. And the golden whip is something which he will cherish for the rest of his life, I have absolutely no doubt. Fantastic scenes here in the winner's enclosure at Maidan after the running of the $10 million World Cup.
It's almost as big as him, the trophy. It's a big, big trophy, isn't it? And, you know, an amazing result for 1-2 for Mahmoud Al-Zarouni. I don't think that'll be the last time we see either Mahmoud or Mikhail win this race in the over plenty of years to come.
And a golden whip for the winning trainer as well. Well, the official off time for this, as we said, is at 10:25. It's over 3,200 metres. It's worth $1 million. It's 12 of them going. We are without number 11, and Christophe Lemaire now rides number 13. That's Casbah Bliss, because Gerard Marseille has got to...